So here we are inside of ON1 Photo RAW. Now, for those of you who are not familiar with the dehaze slider, it's going to be located under tone and color, and then you'll come down to the structure section, and it's going to be the bottom slider here. And what this allows you to do is remove a little bit of haze. So if I pull it to the left, you can see it removes some of that fog or what it's perceiving to be haze. And then if I pull it to the right, it does the same thing. This is very helpful on landscape images or images where there's a lot of fog and it's taken away from the main subject here. First thing that I like to do is pull the haze slider down until I get to a point where I think it looks good over the entire image, and the subject also stands out pretty well. So I think that's pretty good. If I hit the backslash key and let it go, you can see the before and the after. And for many cases, this could be where you stop, but I want to go a little bit further because I think that I can get a little bit more out of this. I haven't done any of my basic adjustments. Now, for situational awareness, I am working on a RAW file, and I do have No Noise AI activated because I have 4,000 ISO used on this image. I need to make sure that I get some of that noise out of there. As far as the exposure goes, what I'm going to do is just push up on my exposure. And you can see that kind of reintroduces the haze. So what I want to do is just pull back on the haze a little bit. And this is a balancing game. Now, note, I'm not using Brilliance AI. And this isn't because I have a problem with Brilliance AI. I think that sometimes to get the best balance of the base image, which this was inspiring to me, in order for me to keep that base image, or at least the spirit of the base image intact, I want to be able to adjust my own tone and color. So this is why it's important to be able to know how to do this for yourself and not just rely on Brilliance AI all the time. So I'm going to go ahead and open up the shadows because I think that that is a little helpful, but there's not much shadow that I need to open in this particular image. And then I'm going to pull back on my highlights. Now that's going to bring down a lot of that brightness, and I'm not sure I want that. Next thing is I'll push the contrast a little bit and push my exposure just a little bit more. So I'm keeping the relative spirit of what was in the initial image, and I may actually pull the haze slider back a little bit more, and I think that that is more of what was in the original image. So the next step is to come over to local, or at least for me, my next step is to come over to local, add an adjustment, we'll reset this from exposure, and you can see in the structure section I have haze all over again. And this is what makes, you know, ON1 so much fun to work in. Let's go ahead and just come over here, and we're going to go with Quick Mask AI Brush. So once this is done evaluating, we'll go ahead and select the bird. So I'm just going to click right there, select the bird. I want to paint this effect in, so I have paint selected, and then I'm just going to hit the blue check mark. That's going to commit the mask over here to our mask icon. And then what I'm going to do is just pull down on this dehaze slider again. And you can see what that does with the bird. And now the bird stands out a little bit more in that fog. So what I could do is just pull the opacity down so it's not as strong. And then we'll also come up to masking, and we will adjust the feather so that way it blends better with the overall image. If I turn this off and turn it back on, you can see how the bird is just a little bit more clear. And I can also increase the structure on the bird so that way the bird looks a little bit more punchy in the image. I can pull down on the blacks because I'm only adjusting the bird, and this is the power of masking. So I can just go ahead and contrast him a little bit, and I don't think I want to make him brighter. I think I'll just leave his tonal value alone, and we'll turn it off and turn it back on. And I think I will pull this mask a little bit more in. So something like that probably looks good, and I'll increase the highlights. Here's what we came into ON1 with, and here is with the dehaze slider. Puts a little bit more emphasis on the bird, and I didn't do a deeper edit on this image. I could definitely do a lot more, to really enhance the image further, I just wanted to kind of showcase the haze slider inside of ON1. So if you got questions, let me know down below. If you want to learn more about ON1 Photo RAW, consider signing up for a training call. There's a link down in the description, and I will be more than happy to walk you through different aspects of ON1 Photo RAW to make sure that you're getting the best that you can out of this software. Until next time, I want you to stay inspired and keep creating. Peace.